A very good afternoon to the board directors, ladies and gentlemen. We are from Arista Consulting. I'm Casey, and the other consultants are Wei Hong, Pauline, and Chester. Let's move forward. We have investigated the critical areas that require the company's immediate attention, and we shall go through these issues with you in order to their urgency. The first main issue is the recommissioned drama series. This followed by the Accident X Studio. Subsequently, we look at the new documentary by the company. Next, it is a fee negotiation for a new children's program. And last but not least, we shall examine whether the company should expand into corporate advertising video. Ladies and gentlemen, let me invite Wei Hong to share with you our analysis for the first two issues.
Thank you, Casey. Ladies and gentlemen, let me represent you the most critical issue, which is recommissioned drama series. We recommend the company to start negotiating with BBC with a discount of 3% and then gradually increase to 5%. This strategy is to maximize the profitability of the new drama series. If BBC does not agree with the rent proposal, then we can proceed by giving a discount between 5 to 9%. If there is no room to negotiate, then we have to agree with 10% discount, which was initially offered by BBC. The next issue is mainly on Johnstrom, who is having a contract with the other company, which is GGG, from 1st of April until 31st of January. But remember, the company plan to start shooting from 1st of December until 31st of March. Therefore, there is an overlapping for 2 months where the company may not be able to get a service from Johnstrom. So, what should we do now? There are three options available. Firstly, compensate GGG and buy out Johnstrom contract. By doing so, the company can retain the popularity of the new drama series, and experienced actor will be more efficient. Finally, Johnstrom can have full concentration in the new drama series. However, it can be costly as the company has to compensate GGG. The next option is get a 2 months look-alike doubles, and then we continue with Johnstrom for another 2 months. Then, by doing so, the company need not compensate and able to maintain the popularity of the new drama series. However, if the real world find out there's not Johnstrom, then the reputation of the company can be at risk. The last option is use a substitute actor and we forget about Johnstrom. By doing so, the company will be able to save costs and start shipping early. However, due to Johnstrom is one of the main actors in the new drama series, without him, the popularity of the new drama series can be at risk. As such, we strongly recommend the company to go for option 2. Next, let's look at the issue on Accident at Studio. There are two options available. The first option is to be status quo. The company can save costs, but the employee's morale will be negatively affected. We also analyze the possibility of compensate the injured worker and hire more set builder. By implying this, the company can maintain ethical value and goodwill to the public, employees' morale will increase, and we have to make sure there's no same accident will happen again. But it can be costly as the company has to compensate to the injured worker. After considering all the factors, we strongly recommend the company to go for option 2. Next, I would like to invite Casey to brief us on subsequent issues. Thank you.
Thank you, Wei Hong. Ladies and gentlemen, let me continue with our analysis on the new documentary to be produced by the company. The issue is whether the company should break even the budget of the new documentary. And we have analyzed three possible options. First, there won't be any more interview and a lesser use of computer graphics interface, in short, CGI. There are advantages and disadvantages associated with this option. The advantages are, the budget of the new documentary can break even, and the company can prevent both operating and net margin from dropping further. But the company may fail to maintain the quality and creativity of the new documentary. And the reputation of the company is at stake if the key messages of the new documentary fail to deliver to the targeted audiences. On the other hand, we have also considered not to conduct any more interview, but a full use of CGI. The advantages are, the company can preserve the quality and creativity of the new documentary, and the company can mitigate the forecasted loss of £30,000 partially. However, the reputation of the company may be negatively affected due to the inconsistencies the evidences gathered from the repeated interviews. And remember, the company still has to incur the loss partially. Third and last alternative that we have analyzed is to conduct more interviews and the full use of CGI. The advantages are, it is highly possible for the company to win an award due to the outstanding and innovative content of the new documentary. And the company will be well positioned for securing future documentary commission. Moreover, the new documentary also provides a great opportunity for the company to achieve high margin from international sales, as the global financial crisis of 2008 is an appealing topic to global audiences. The main disadvantage is the possible loss of £30,000 for the company. Despite of the loss, the advantages outweigh the disadvantage. As such, we strongly recommend the company to adopt option 3. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe you might have asked this question in your mind. How then are we supposed to mitigate the possible loss of £30,000 and turn it into profit? Let us share the strategies with you. First, the company can sell the finished documentary to overseas broadcasters for additional revenues and consider selling it to international DVD distributors to earn royalties from international DVD sales. Also, the company can sell the digital content of the new documentary to international publishers for book publishing. Alternatively, the company can even produce a brand new documentary that explains why the European debt crisis happened in May 2009. With the experience gained from making the existing documentary, we believe that the company will be able to save more operating costs to increase the margin. Ladies and gentlemen, let me invite Chester to share with you our analysis on the fourth issue.
Our analysis on the issue of fee negotiation for new children program. After we have done our analysis, we found that there are two possible options for the company to choose. It revolves around whether should the company accept the initial deal with the broadcaster, or should the company accept a 35% lower fees in return for the rights to sell semi-squirrel merchandises. Therefore, we shall then examine both options in detail. The first option provides the company a higher fixed revenue as compared with the second option. It also allows the company to bear lesser responsibility and risk. With lesser responsibility, the company actually able to focus more of its resources into its core business. This option, however, led the company to forego the opportunity to earn a high potential margin. The second option, in contrast, led the company to earn an opportunity to earn a high potential margin, and it's also enhance the company's reputation in children producing children program. It also, however, expose the company into international competition and might let the company to face losses if there is no intention from the broadcaster If there is no intention from broadcaster to recommission semi-squirrel. We also further examine the degree of impact from both options. We begin by comparing both options' fixed revenue. As we can see here, the fixed revenue of first option provides £6.5 million, and the second option fixed revenue provides a fixed revenue of approximately £4.1 million. It implies that the second option needs an additional revenue of £2.2 million in order for it to break even with the first option. Please bear in mind that this £2.2 million is the residual amount after the distribution of profit among all business partners. Therefore, we incorporated the £2.2 million into our subsequent calculation, along with the share margin that will agree with all business partners, namely the broadcaster and the outsourcer. And we found that the total merchandising sales that would require to break even amounted to £22 million. Please take note that the company actually has a share margin directly from the total merchandising sales of 10%. So we have the break-even requirement. How are we going to project the possible sales for Semi-Squirrel? We refer to Teletubbies, a renowned children program in the late 1990s, as our basis to project the possible sales for Semi-Squirrel. According to BBC News, we found that BBC Worldwide actually earned £5 million in 1997, contributed from the Teletubbies merchandises. By using the same calculation, which incorporated all business partners and their share margin, we found that the merchandising sales in year 1997 amounted to £125 million. We didn't just stop there, because we are aware that Teletubbies was almost 15 years ago. Therefore, the average inflation rate was incorporated, and we found that the equivalent sales value amounted to £186 million. As we can see just now, the company would earn a 10% share of profit. Therefore, here implies that the company would have a return of £18.6 million. By considering all the calculations we have done just now, we strongly recommend the company to venture into the second option. This is because the second option provides a fixed revenue of £4.1 million. It requires only £2.2 million for them to break even. In fact, we have projected the sales for the company, which were contributed by Semi-Squirrel merchandises, which will amount to £18.6 million. The disparity among what is required and what is projected is amount to £12.33 million. This is the amount that persuades us to recommend you the second option. Coming up, I would like to invite Pauling to present you our analysis on the fifth issue.
Thank you, Chester. Now, very good afternoon once again to everyone. Now, let us go to our last issue, whether the company should expand into corporate advertising video market segment to increase the bottom line of the company. Should the company reject the proposal? The advantage of this will be no cash outflows incurred and no risk of expansion. The disadvantage will be the severe loss of opportunities. Board of Directors, if we were to accept the proposal, there are many opportunities available for the company. We will be able to increase the profits, increase the market shares, increase the customer base, and will be able to diversify the company's portfolio. In addition, the expansion also keeps the company up to date with the market trends. Last but not least, this would enable the company to utilize its human capital to the most effective and efficient way. However, there may be some minor disadvantages. The company may incur a small initial outlay, and as usual for new businesses, there will be risk involved. And we still have to take it. Ladies and gentlemen, no risk, no gain. Moving on, let's look at some figures. These are the three possible scenarios we have analyzed for the first production of corporate advertising video. The average, best, and worst situation. In the average situation, the company may incur a loss of £700. However, this amount is immaterial compared to the company's operating profits of more than £3 million. In the best situation, the company may make a profit of £500. When it turns out to be the worst case scenario, the company may incur a loss of £1,500. Nevertheless, from the second and subsequent production, your company will be able to save the production cost up to 15%. Under the three same scenarios, the company will be able to make a profit about £3,000 in the bad situation. In the average situation, there will be a profit about £2,000. Even in the worst case scenario, your company will still be able to make a profit about £1,300. As such, we strongly recommend the company to accept the proposal. The potential The potential future growth in this industry is very high. As you can see from the graph, the industry is enjoying a rapid growth of 128% for the past 2 years. Directors, in conclusion, let us refresh our main recommendations. First, for the recommissioned drama series, we would strongly recommend the company to employ a temporarily substitute actors for the first 2 months while John Strong is not available, and to negotiate a higher fee with BBC. Secondly, the company should compensate and hire more workers to prevent future accidents happening at the studio. On the new documentary, we would strongly recommend the company to carry out more interviews and full use of computer graphics interface. The company also should consider the long-term benefits from the international sales expansion. Next, for the new children's program, we would strongly recommend the company to accept a lower fee in return for the rights to make and sell Savage Squirrel merchandise. Lastly, the expansion into corporate advertising video market segment is highly recommended, simply because your company has a good start for the drama series last year and received good responses. Since the commencement of international sales in 2008, the company's revenue increased steadily, and it turns out to be the highest profit margin. Board of Directors, this shows that your company is actually able to accept new challenges and performing well at the same time fulfilling the market demands. To conclude, ladies and gentlemen, a business that adopting going concern principle should always make decisions based on long-term benefits. Hence, the company should consider having a studio of its own to improve the overall performance of the companies. To wrap up our presentation, I would like to leave you some words by Abraham Maslow. You will either step forward into growth or you will step backward into safety. Thank you.